the church is, if it's the man, then it's wrong. If a church said, I'm demanding you to pay this, that's wrong.
Why do you get on radio and ask for donations?
Because, you know, people need help.
All right, if you get some money, what you going to do with it?
I'm going to put it to the use of what the Lord has me to put it to the use of.
What Lord told you to do with the money? Buy your car?
You can pay your bills.
I got pay your bills.
Ain't paying now.
You gonna take somebody else's money and pay your bills?
No, sir. It don't work that way.
What you gonna do
if
with the money?
If you are all children of God, you supposed to help one another and love one another.
Wait a minute here. If some people give you some money, what are you gonna do with the money?
I'm going to help. I'm going to pay my bills.
You gonna take money that people give to the church and pay your own damn bills?
I'm gonna do whatever is in the forefront. If I got an electric bill that I cannot handle and I go to the church and say, no, can y'all help me with it, then I think that's not
how you going
to
sit here on radio and talk about people giving tithe offerings to the church because the church is misusing the money. And I just asked you, if people gave you some money, what was you going to do with the money? And you said you're going to take the money and pay your light bill at home.
Churches get big money. King Fitz, all that big money these churches get out here. Churches get big money. And a lot of times, the churches get big money and overlook the little man. And see, that's the thing. That's the
so
thing.
Are you jealous because they're getting more money than you getting?
Excuse me?
Are you jealous because the other preachers are getting more money than you getting?
No, I mean, if they're getting the money, they can get what they want to get, but if they're not doing the right thing with it, but you should not put a demand on someone paying tithes. No, you don't put a demand on it. You don't do that.
I'm not saying putting a demand on people.
But you got people that put demands on it.
I ain't talking about the people. I'm talking about you right now, Bishop. You said that if some people gave you some money to your church, I asked you, what you going to do with the money?
Well,
you said you're
going to
pay your light bill and some other things.
The money's going to help other people. If they gave it to my church, it's going to go to help the other people that are less fortunate. And that's what I think God will want.
So you're going to take yours off top?
No, I ain't taking mine off top. But I've seen pastors take theirs off top.
Where are you going to get your money from?
I'm going to keep praying. And whatever God sends, he sends my way. Now, like I say, I know pastors that I've been to the church, and they said, well, the mother of the church need a brand new car. Here go my $1,000. Okay, once they collect that money.
Well, where that church at? I'd like to go to that church because Kingfish could use a new car here today.
I'm just saying, once they collect that money, the pastor goes in the back and he take his off the top. So therefore, the pastor.
Well, how you know all this going on, Bishop?
Huh?
How you know all this is going on unless you're part of it?
I've been around and heard them and seen it.
So you mean to tell me when somebody is doing something crooked, they let you come in the room and see them doing something crooked in the church?
They let me come in the room.
So how you know?
Because they respect people that usually when you go to another church and you new, then they respect you and tell you, do you want to sit here or sit there? But I can tell you this much, I know they have actually taken theirs off the top once they said, well, we need this much to raise this, and they put theirs in there, and then they come back, then they take it off the top, and that's not right. They take theirs back off the top. And that's not right.
You're talking against preachers here today.
I'm not talking against preachers. I'm just saying you told me to tell the truth, and that's what I'm doing, telling the truth. They will take that off the top. Yes, they take it off the top.
So
a preacher can say, okay, this is what I'm saying, Kingfish. A preacher can say, we need $500 so we can paint our church. Okay. He said, here's my first $100. Okay. Once he showed his that $100, everybody started going in their pocket, but who has? That's why, going back to tithes, who has? It's not the man to pay a tenth. And the lady that was on the phone last, no, miss, you're wrong. Go back to your Bible. It's not a man. When you demand somebody to pay some tithes, you got a problem.
Well, you just said that a preacher might get up and say, we need some money. I'm going to give the first $100. He's not demanding, he's asking.
Right, I'm going to get that. But when he raises his $100 bill up in the air, then you can have the others that bring that money and they pass the plate around. When they pass the plate around, they tell the people, go in the back and count it. When they go in the back and count it, the preacher take his $100 back all of there and say, look here, this is how much we have raised. And that is true and that is a fact.
You're saying that the preacher will take money out of the basket?
I'm saying that once the preacher hold up his $100, he going to start the money. He holds up $100. Well, I put in the first $100, and then the basket goes around. Then there's two people that goes in the back, or two or three, and counts it. He takes his $100 back out and put it in his pocket. Yes, they do.
How do you know this?
Oh, I got some sauces.
So it means you done did it too then?
I decided did that.
No, have you ever done that?
No, I ain't did that.
Now how you know other preachers are doing this?
Because I heard the preacher say it around his mouth.
So you talking gossip now?
I ain't talking no gossip.
Have you actually seen it?
I've seen it.
Then why would you be part of it then?
I wasn't part of it. I was visiting the church.
Look here, Bishop.
And that turned me off. I was visiting the church and I saw it and it turned me off.
Look here, Bishop. If you are in a church and you goes in the back and they count his monies and this preacher take $100 out and say, I'm going to get mine back and put it in his pocket, why wouldn't you say something to him?
Because that's that man's church. I told him it wasn't right, then I left. I ain't been back there since.
No, I'm not saying it's not. Suppose somebody trying to rob somebody and you see it and you wouldn't say, look, don't do that, that's wrong.
If somebody robs somebody, I mean, you know, why are they robbing them for? I mean, there's a whole lot of crime going on here these days, Kingfish. And somebody robs somebody, yeah, it's wrong. But
what kind of preacher you going to be here?
I'm telling you, I'm answering the question you're asking me to answer. I'm just saying what I said, that you got the doctrine of salvation.
What I'm hearing here today, Bishop, is that you one of these preachers that will turn your back or turn your eye when something is done wrong.
No,
You sat here, you said that you got a whole lot of homosexual friends.
Yeah, I do.
If somebody give you some money for your church, you're going to pay your light bill. You don't see nothing wrong with having sexual relationships. What kind of preacher are you?
I don't see nothing wrong with having sexual relationships. What's wrong with having sexual relationships? You're married, ain't you?
You ain't married, though.
Who ain't married?
Well, your wife ain't with you.
I'm just saying. I said ain't nothing wrong with having a sexual relationship if you're married.
You participated in orgies when you was in school.
I said in high school I saw a couple of orgies. I didn't say I'm to be no orgies now. I said in high school I saw them.
You saw them?
Yeah, I saw them.
You saw them because you was in the same room.
I said it was going to a game, and then at the game, after the game, then we used to have little parties. Then after the party, they used to do the thing.
Yeah, but if you got baptized when you was 8 and started preaching and when you was 10, you don't get in high school till you get about 12.
Yeah.
So you was doing all this stuff as a minister.
No, Kingfish, somebody invite you up to their house, and you 16, 17 years old.
Yeah, but you was a minister.
I didn't know what they were doing.
You saw it.
When I saw it, I left.
But that's not being a good minister.
Why was it that? Stand there and join them?
Because you was in an impressionable age, and you had impressionable age people around you who were your friends. And if you are called by God to be a minister, you should have ministered to your friends and said, look, you are wrong.
I say they wrong and I left, King. I ain't join them.
I don't know here. You might have joined them one time.
No, I ain't joined them. I said, look here, I can't take part in this. And I left, and that's fine.
So what do you do with your homosexual friends?
After I left, I prayed for them.
All right, what do you do with your homosexual friends?
My homosexual friends, I minister to them.
Okay, now you can minister to them, but the other ones that have an orgy, you couldn't minister to them.
They was into some serious stuff. I couldn't minister to them right then.
Well, how serious is homosexuality?
That's some serious stuff too, but still I can minister to them. But see, because they want sometimes be one person, but the order is like a lot of people. Huh?
Because you one of them.
Is I'm a homosexual?
I believe you're a homosexual.
No, not homosexual. No, I'm not homosexual. No.
But when did you stop being a homosexual?
No, I'm not I've not been homosexual.
Then why you have so many friends who are homosexuals?
Because everybody else turned their backs on them.
So just because somebody turned their back on them, you got to take them off, huh?
Well, I mean, you know, I'm not going to turn my back on them because they're homosexual, because I feel as though they are a human being. They are human. They are human beings. God created Adam and Eve. They are human.
I think you're a jackleg preacher.
Look at Solomon and Gomorrah. You know the story of Solomon and Gomorrah. Okay, all kind of stuff, you know. Look at Lot when he asked for the men and said that he and not to take my daughters instead of the men. So we have to look at things in the eyes of truth here. And the things of truth here, if I walk outside and see a homosexual and they speak, I'm gonna speak to them.
I reckon you will speak to them. You probably take them home with you.